What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. Thanks so much for clicking on this video. Today, we're going to be doing kind of like the part two of my hygiene routine video that I uploaded a few days ago. I guess you could call that like a teaser, trailer, introduction. I don't really know, but yeah, we're gonna go ahead and jump right into this video. Just to let y'all know, I won't be including like any skincare for my face in this video, only because I plan to do a separate video of my updated skincare routine coming up soon. There's been a lot of stuff going on with my skin, my face, so yeah, I had to change a lot of stuff around from the last like two, well, the last ones that you saw, last two that you saw. So yeah, things are different definitely about my skincare, but I will definitely keep y'all updated and do an updated video very soon. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and go through some of my hygiene products, just stuff that I love, stuff that I use, stuff that might be able to help you guys if you are looking for maybe a new product. I don't know, but this is just my hygiene routine. I'm also really excited about this routine because I just feel like there is, you know, some things are very touchy subjects. Some things are not talked about full out, and I know there are a ton of videos, but everybody has different ways of doing things. So hopefully with this series and me uploading more videos just about hygiene and feminine care and just women's care and care in general, it will be able to help somebody else. I know there are a lot of young girls, just people in general. Maybe they don't have someone to talk to. Maybe they don't, you know, have their mom or their aunt or anything. Sometimes you just don't want to ask questions outright. It could be uncomfortable to ask your mom about certain things or ask your, you know, about certain things or your cousin, whoever. So hopefully watching videos like this are helpful for you guys. So yeah, let's stop rambling and I'm gonna jump right into this video. So to first start off, I always start with just my body wash, of course. Once you get in the shower, like, you know, you want to wet your entire body, you know, wet your entire body. Don't just jump in and immediately start putting soap on. It's just like your hair. Your body needs to come in contact with water first, okay? Water. And preferably not cold, okay? Don't, you know, use lukewarm, warm water, not too hot, but just, you know, right in the middle. And so once you are nice and, you know, moisturized with the water, I like to go in with my Aveeno Daily Moisture Body Wash for dry skin. I love the smell of this. This one bottle lasts a long time, at least like 3 weeks, I would say. This body wash is just really nourishing. Like, I can get out of the shower and not use lotion. Well, sometimes I can get out of the shower and not use lotion and, you know, or not lotion up right away. And this just makes sure that I stay moisturized. So this is the Aveeno, like I said, and I just really love it because of the fact that it is super moisturizing and it has a nice scent to it, but it doesn't have like, it doesn't make you feel dry and rough after your shower. And then I go in with some type of Soap and Glory products. I am a Soap and Glory like fiend. I love Soap and Glory. This smells amazing. So I'll go in with like my Aveeno twice and then finish off with my Soap and Glory. This one bottle, because I only use it, you know, once during my shower, this one bottle actually can last me an entire month. And again, really moisturizing and nourishing to your skin. So you don't have to worry about it being like harsh or making you feel dry after your shower. Okay, so another thing that I love to use in the shower, normally I go between my Honey Pot and this, the Honey Pot feminine wash. This one, which is the Vagisil sensitive daily intimate wash, and this is in the White Jasmine scent. Ever since I started using this, I haven't really been using anything else though. This is just my favorite intimate wash. This is the one that I've been using for like the last 2 months now, and I really like it. It's really gentle. Again, I don't like super goopy, like thick, weird smelling feminine washes. I'm really picky about my washes as well, so if it's not this one or the Honey Pot or the Summer's Eve Natural, the foam one, I like that one also. But between those three, I don't really use anything else. So this one is my favorite. And again, this is a good sized bottle, so it lasts, you know, a good amount of time. Okay, so also in the shower, y'all saw me talk about this product in my TJ Maxx haul. That's where I got it from. I absolutely love this Scrub-A-Dub-Dub exfoliating body scrub. This is in the scent Sweet Jasmine, and it's by the Body Prescriptions brand. I don't know if you can see that, probably not, but it's by the Body Prescriptions brand, y'all. I love to dry scrub with this. I just love this product because it's super moisturizing. A lot of times I will actually exfoliate, as you saw in my hygiene routine. I will exfoliate with this, and then as I'm exfoliating, like toward the end, it turns into like this cream. I can't really explain it, but it turns into a cream, and I just go right in with my razor and I'll like shave my legs. Normally this is how I shave my legs, and it leaves them so smooth and so soft. I love this stuff. So I'm gonna try and link it in the bottom. But this is the Scrub-a-Dub-Dub Exfoliating Body Scrub in Sweet Jazz. Okay, so recently after I get out of the shower, I actually have been taking some of this Dickerson's Pore Perfecting Toner and using it under my arms with just a cotton swab. I feel like in the summer, your pores, you know, you don't just have pores on your face. You have pores all over your body, obviously. Like the pores, like, you know, under your arms are super important, especially when it's summertime and it's sweating. So for this entire summer, I've actually been using this and I think it works. I think that it helps just with like sweating and making sure that your pores don't get clogged with deodorant, which is something that I was dealing with, or I am dealing with. So I'm trying to like combat that, helping to just make sure that my pores stay clean, because having all of that stuff under there sitting on top of each other does not help with the smell in the summer. All right, and this is the deodorant that I've been using. This is the Dove Advanced Care Caring Coconut. I normally don't get deodorants with scents to them. I normally am like a degree type person. I even use Arm & Hammer sometimes. You know, especially in the summer, we just can't be funky, so. But this one, the scent is not too bad. It's not like overpowering, so I just grabbed it because it was on sale, honestly. If it's Degree or Dove, I'll use it. All right, so then I like to move to moisturizing my skin, obviously. I talked about my Cetaphil body lotion in my eczema video. I absolutely love this body lotion. I feel like a little bit goes a long way, and it definitely keeps me moisturized all day long, so I don't ever have to worry about that. And then a lot of times, only at night though, especially, well, I'll say in the summer, I don't use this and go outside, but like at night and even in the winter, I absolutely love another Soap & Glory product. I'm telling you. I absolutely love this Righteous Butter from Soap & Glory. This is like my favorite butter that they have. And I just like to put this on at night after my Cetaphil, because when I wake up in the morning, y'all, my skin is so, so soft. And it's very lightweight. It's a lightweight butter. It's still moisturizing, but it's not like super thick and heavy and obnoxious like some butters can be. All right, so recently, your girl has really like bad cuticles and really dry hands. I did not know that I suffered from dry hand syndrome. I didn't know that I had that problem until recently. So I've been using this L'Octane, Cream Mains, I think it's called. Yeah, Cream Mains Dry Hand Cream. And I actually have been using this on my feet too. Like, it's that thick and it's that good, and it keeps them both moisturized. So I know it says for hands, but I've been using it for feet. I'm not a really huge fan of like body splashes or body sprays, to be honest. I have a select few that I like, and majority of them are from Pink. This is hands down my favorite body spray of all time. I believe that it's discontinued. So the last time I went, they had them on sale for like $2.99. So I got like four or five of them. But this is the Urban Bouquet from Pink. I don't like scents. Now that I'm just getting older, I don't really like scents that smell like too kiddish, if that makes sense. So between these two, this one is the Warm and Cozy and this one is the Urban Bouquet. These are like my two go-to body sprays. I'm the type of person that puts on body spray at night. I don't know if that's like doing too much, but that's just me. I only put on like actual perfume, like spray one of my actual perfumes if I'm actually going someplace, like if I'm going to work or like, you know, but if I'm just like ripping and running my daily, you know, go-tos, it's between these two and also my Sol de Janeiro. This is the Brazilian Crush, y'all. This is absolutely amazing. I love this more so for fall. All right, y'all, that is pretty much the basics of my hygiene routine. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Of course, like I said, I have more videos to come within this series, you know, touching more specifically on certain topics and certain things. So yeah, thanks so much for clicking on this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will talk to you guys in my next one.